Welcome back, everyone. I'm Robbie.
And I'm Liam.
And The Merc with the Mouth has finally hit the big screen again. Deadpool 2 is in theatres. We've both seen it. Jai is actually going to step out of this one because he hasn't seen it. So it's just the two of us today. Hope you enjoy.
Oh, you're living the dreams, DP.
Yeah.
Devil may care attitude. Strong thighs. Beautiful girlfriend.
Sorry I'm late. I was rounding up all the gluten in the world and launching into space where it can't not hurt us ever again.
Kiss me like you miss me, Red.
What in the fucksicle is this?
My name's Cable. I'm here for the kid.
What?
Deadpool 2 was directed by David Leitch, and it stars, of course, Ryan Reynolds, and he's joined by Josh Brolin, what's the kid from Hunt from Wheeler People's
it's
name?
Julian
Dennison, that's it. Julian Dennison and TJ Miller.
Yeah, and it's basically about a new character, Cable, who's come back in time to, for whatever reason, kill Julian
Dennison's.
Yeah, Dennison's character. And Deadpool has to stop him.
Yeah. It's kind of the plot of Terminator 2 in a way.
Yeah, just very satirical.
Yeah.
Very over the top.
Which of course they reference briefly in the film.
Yeah.
Overall thoughts, what did you think of it? You're a fan of the original one,
yeah,
right? Yeah, me too.
I think that the first one's really great. I think that it sort of came at the right time. It was this special new thing, and it was refreshing for like the superhero genre, which was sort of getting fatigued.
It was the first R-rated one.
Yeah, first R-rated one, and it made a lot of money, which they make light of in this film. I think that this film is not as good. In fact, I don't know if I think it's that good just in general. I think it's above average. I did enjoy myself while watching it, but it was very convoluted, and there are a lot of things that just didn't mesh up. And considering how streamlined the first one was, like, it was so straightforward, it's just sort of disappointing in a way.
Yeah, I do agree with you with the number of those things. It is not as good as the first one. I still had a really great time watching it, but I definitely walked out feeling less satisfied than the first one.
Yeah.
A lot of it being to do, like, Deadpool, I thought, was once again nailed perfectly by Ryan Reynolds. Josh Brolin was a great addition to the cast when he appears.
Yeah.
He takes a while to appear, but once he does come on screen, he's great.
Mm.
For me, the problem was the focus of the film. It feels very almost too crowded at times.
Yeah.
And I don't know if it's just because we're used to the first one, which is really a very simple origin story, disguised almost as a love story, the first one. This one, I mean, the whole tagline of this one is, it feels bigger. And it does feel bigger, but obviously bigger doesn't always mean better.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you can see, not just with the jokes, but with the, I mean, the action's great, but you can see the whole film is trying to outdo the other.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of it just outdoing the other, you can just feel it just wants to be that movie and it doesn't really get there.
Yeah, I mean, once you've hit the popularity and success of
yeah.
the first film, it would be hard for anyone to recapture it.
Yeah.
But it really doesn't get anywhere near. At least in my eyes, it doesn't.
Mm.
First of all, the film starts like 3 times. Like,
yeah, it does, actually.
The first act,
I haven't thought of that, but it does.
Yeah, the first act is just kind of badly paced.
I feel that's the whole film, though. I feel like it never knows when each sequence starts.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And because of that, it just has no focus. And it was hard for me to remain focused when it didn't know what it was doing, or
right.
it was jumping from scene to scene, not staying on things long enough. And then
staying
on other things
way too long.
Yeah,
there's a certain joke towards the end. You know the one I mean. It just milks it way too much,
mm-hmm.
and you know it was going on, and I was like, okay, this joke's on a way thin, and it's still going. I was like, okay, move on, and it's still going.
Yeah,
like, wow,
yeah.
They're actually still going at this. Is what 2 minutes into the joke? I'm like, enough, guys. It's
it just stops being funny.
Mm.
That's just the way it is. I feel like, in terms of positives, because I haven't really said anything that I've liked yet, I do like a lot about this film. I think that all the action scenes actually trump the first film.
Oh, the action scenes, I mean, it's directed by David Leitch, who did Atomic Blonde, which I haven't
mm-hmm.
seen, but he did John Wick.
Yeah, he
which has incredible action.
Mm-hmm.
And this one, it does definitely outdo it. What I find is, though, like the, can't remember the director of the first one.
Tim Miller.
Tim Miller, that's it, yeah.
Yeah.
He obviously had a love for the character. So while maybe his action scenes weren't always as completely well done as this one, overall, the tone was there.
Yeah, absolutely.
Here, I find, I just don't think, I mean, John Wick's a very serious film. And that's obviously David Leitch's strength. I don't know if he's a great comedy director.
No. I think that he sort of relied a lot on Ryan Reynolds to do his own thing. I think that a lot of people would have relied
and,
on Ryan Reynolds.
I mean, you can kind of see why, because Ryan Reynolds knows the character inside and out.
Yeah, he is Deadpool.
At the same time, even actors who are amazing do need to be reined in sometimes, and there's no control over what... You can see that, like, there's so many moments I'm like, okay, that's definitely a cutting room floor joke that was just left in because they want to leave it in. And there's no reason for that joke to be there.
Yeah. And the film tries at points to be, like more emotional, I think, than the first film.
It does. And it succeeds in some ways, I think, for me.
I didn't think it really landed, honestly. But, like, going back to the jokes parts of it, it would feel like some parts they would have a serious moment, then they'd cut it off with a joke, and it sort of wouldn't work. And then other parts where they would have a serious moment, and you're like, okay, where's the joke? And it doesn't happen.
Yeah.
It's very inconsistent.
It is. When I say, like, the emotional beats work, it worked for me, like, when it starts, and that whole emotional through line begins, I was on board with that.
Yeah.
I just find it gets weak towards the end. But it did have me on board for quite a while. I think it's the payoff with this film. It doesn't have a payoff, really.
Yeah.
Like, the first one did. Like, the whole Francis storyline was amazing. And there's nothing that... You know what? I think this is a villain problem.
Yeah.
There's no actual standout villain in this film. Because, okay, this is obviously spoiler-free. We're not going to spoil anything.
No.
But... Cable is not the big bad
that
the trailers make him out to be.
No, he's not.
He is menacing. He is a opponent they have to overcome. But there isn't actually a villain, really, in the film like Francis was in the first one.
Mm-hmm. And
Ajax.
Yeah, named himself after a laundry detergent. You're totally right on that. I think that for as basic as Ajax Francis was... He got the job done, you know. He worked. He was simplistic. He was two dimensional, but he worked for the revenge plot that the first film was trying to tell.
Yeah.
And because this film doesn't really know what plot it wants to tell, it doesn't really know what villain it wants to have, and it just sort of makes everything just go from one track to another to another to another.
The thing I used to cope in now is like, hang on. Villains.
Yeah, that's like, I think they've got a good idea, but it just doesn't really work or pay off.
Look, overall, I still had a really great time with this film. I think it's because I love watching Ryan Reynolds play the character so much, and like I said, he does it so well. The X-Force was surprisingly offbeat, which I really loved. They do something with the team that completely caught me off guard, and I loved that.
That was actually a really
that was
really good scene.
And like, there's a lot of moments like that that are really great. It's just there's too many moments that bring it down from where I would have liked it to be. Star rating, were you going for it?
Star rating. I still think that the film is above average.
Mm-hmm.
It's just kind of incompetent, and it's got so many good things and so many bad things meshed together. But like, it's hard to give it a high recommendation. I'd probably give it 3 stars, I think.
Right.
You know, and it's an above average film. It's still enjoyable. It's just very all over the place.
Yeah, and I can definitely see where you're coming from. I definitely agree with you. Just not probably as strongly. The enjoyment I have of this film does still outweigh overall the negatives I have of the film. Like, the negatives didn't ruin the experience. They just didn't make the experience as great as it could have been.
Yeah, absolutely.
I gave the first one 4.5, like a very strong 4.5. I'll go 4 stars with this one.
Now, let's go get our fuck on. Don't call it a comeback. I've been here for years. I'm rocking my fears. What the fuck is in fear? Making the tears rain down like a monsoon. Listen to the bass going.
Tell me they got that in slow motion.
Doing the right thing is messy. But if you want to fight for what's right, sometimes you have to fight dirty. And that is why Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants is pure pornography.
Oh, God, I wish I finished college.
Hey guys, thanks for watching our review of Deadpool 2. If you enjoyed it, make sure to give us a comment and show us any support you can, and keep an eye out for any videos we make in the future.
Including our spoiler review for this movie, mm-hmm. which will be up very shortly.
Indeed. Until next time, we'll see you at the movies.